powerful, impactful, life-changing. This is the teaching ministry of Apostle Faithman Ogboada, where supernatural things are happening through the anointed word of God. This prolific preacher and dynamic teacher of God's word is changing lives all over the world. Are you ready? Because your life will never be the same.
Your success is directly related to your submission to God's word.
We are not here to do what we think or feel. We are here to do what God's word has approved.
If you're going to succeed in life, God must come first in everything you do.
Faith in God does not fail because its origin is God.
Here is Apostle Faithman Ogboada.
Lord, we glorify you. Lamb of God, we bless you. El Shaddai, we bless you. The blessing will overtake you. The prayer was a confirmation of what God spoke to me yesterday. The blessing will overtake you. Lord, we thank you for this month of February. And we thank you for the remaining days of 2017 and beyond. We thank you for the blessing. We thank you for the release of the blessing. Thank you because we are walking in the blessing. Thank you because we have a light of the blessing. The blessings of the Lord make us rich and add no sorrow. No sorrow to the blessing. The blessing is in operation. Lord, we thank you for the blessing. Thank you for the blessing. Everyone watching this morning, the blessing is on you.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
Amen.
Amen.
We can take us to next morning. Hallelujah. The month of February is an awesome month. The wife, she was praying and talking about the blessing. I didn't share with her what God dropped in my heart. He said to us that this month of February, the blessing will overtake you.
Amen.
That's the prophetic word.
I receive in Jesus' name.
This is the month where the blessing will overtake you.
Amen.
The blessing is God's ability at work in you.
Thank you.
Empowering you to have the God kind of experience. The blessing is the ability of God at work in you, empowering you to have the God kind of experience. The blessing is the ability of God in you, empowering you to have the God kind of experience. So the blessing empowers. When Isaac wanted to die, he said to Esau, go prepare me a venison, something I will eat, as I can bless you. Because the blessing can be transferred. And when the blessing is in operation, no impossibility can limit the manifestation of your powers. When the blessing is in operation. You see, God wants us to have what is called the blessing mindset. The mindset of the blessing. He said that the blessing will overtake me. One of the ways I'm going to see supernatural increase is when I function in the revelation of the blessing. Can you think this way? I am blessed. No. This is how God wants you to think. That I'm blessed. I am blessed. He wants that consciousness to dominate your way of thinking. The consciousness that I am blessed. We are called into the blessed life. The life that originates from the very nature of the Father God. We are called into the blessed life. In Ephesians 1 verse 3, We're going to read that in Deuteronomy, but let's look at Ephesians 1 verse 3. Praise the Lord. In Ephesians chapter 1 verse 3, I'm called into what? Into the blessed life. Life as the Father has it. Dominion as the Father has it. Authority as the Father has it. In Ephesians 1 verse 3, it said, blessed be the God. It said, blessed be the God. Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who had blessed us. A blessed man cannot be stranded. There is something about the blessing. The blessing exonerates an individual from limitations. If there is a limitation or an opposition, and this person gets to realize how blessed he or she is in Christ Jesus, the blessing is a yoke breaker. The blessing is a yoke breaker. And that was how Joseph prospered in Egypt, because the blessing was on him. Because he was the seed of Abraham. And if you're the seed of Abraham, you're carrying the blessing. Don't try to break through. See, the door's already open before you. Don't try to break through. Don't try to make it happen. If you are conscious that you're blessed, then your activities will be directed by the Spirit. If you're conscious that you are blessed, your activities will be directed by the Spirit. There is something about a blessing that causes you to prosper in dry places. They said this place is dry, not to walk here. Nobody prospers here. Then the blessed man step into the place, the climate change. Because the blessing is a climate changer. The blessing changes climates. It changes atmosphere. Maybe the organization is a broke organization, nothing works. We saw a practical example of that in the life of Joseph when he stepped into the house of Potiphar. Things shifted. Because the guy came with a blessing. And when people show up with a blessing, when a blessed man show up in a place, things change. When you marry a blessed man, your life get better. When you marry a blessed woman, your life get better. There is something about the blessing that give people great identity. There is something about the blessing. When someone is blessed, curses don't prevail around them. Nobody can curse the blessed man. When a man is blessed, and how did he become a blessed man? His submission to the Lordship of Jesus brought him into the blessed life. His submission to the Lordship of Jesus brought him into the blessed life. His submission to the Lordship of Jesus brought him into the blessed life. You may have known him before when he used to, nothing was working, everything about his life. But just notice, just study him. I'll tell you why you notice a change. I'll tell you why you notice a change. I'll tell you why you notice a change. The blessing keep moving him from one dimension to the other. That's how you do a blessing. You get to know them when they used to squat in one room. But because of the blessing, they moved to two-bedroom apartments. Because of the blessing. But because of that same blessing, they moved to three-bedroom apartments. But because of that same blessing, they buy homes. He said the blessings of the Lord make it rich. So what brings the riches is the blessing. He said, the blessings of the Lord make it rich and add no sorrow. When you're truly blessed, you don't have to deceive people or manipulate people or take advantage of people, because the blessing itself has the potential to create prosperity. The blessing of the Lord. He said, he make it rich. So having the revelation of the blessing is the key to supernatural success. When you have the revelation that I am blessed, look at what Jesus did in Luke chapter 4. If you read from verse 18 to 19, he said, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because he's anointed me. what do you call that? The blessed consciousness. The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because He has anointed me. You see, when you're walking the revelation of a blessing, no opposition can hinder the manifestation of your greatness. Walking in the revelation of the blessing. It's so powerful. Folks may sit down and say, we're going to curse him, we're going to do this to him, we're going to do that. Oh, no rush. Somebody can say, I'm not going to support you anymore, I withdraw my support. They just made a mistake. 100 other people came and said, supporting you. Yeah. Their presence never counted anymore. You know why? The blessing puts you ahead of your workers.
Hallelujah.
It puts you ahead. They are trying to drag you down. They are trying to put you down. But suddenly you notice you went up. That's what I call the blessing. It pushes you forward. The blessing is the reason why folks can let go of things for you that they work hard to get.
Mm-hmm.
The blessing is the reason why folks could look at you and say, I want you to buy it. I don't care whether you have the money or not. I want you to buy it. The blessing.
Bless
her. It attracts treasures.
Ah, hallelujah.
The blessing. That was why Joseph left home. When he left home with that coat of many colors, on the way, they took that coat of many colors from him. They thought the coat of many colors was what was lifting him, unknowing to them that the blessing is something that lives in people. That lives in the person. And you know what happened? They took that coat of many color. They betrayed him. They lied against him. They sold him out as a slave. But the blessing was not sold out.
Hallelujah. Thank you.
The blessing escorted him in the journey.
Mm-hmm.
He was in that journey with the blessing. So every rejection, accusation, opposition, disagreement, manipulation could not affect him because the blessed people, when a man is truly blessed, it is difficult to subdue him.
Hallelujah.
Because there is a cloud that goes with him. It's a cloud that goes with that man. Because he's blessed, there is a cloud of the glory of the Father that goes with this blessed man. That was why I said the blessings of the Lord make it rich. The blessing puts him ahead of his equals. The blessing puts my head of his equals. The blessing puts my head of his equals. When his equals is trying to get count one, he has counted 20.
Mm-hmm.
When his equals are trying to do two, he has done 50. When his equals are trying to touch, go to this place, yes, his voice is already there. You know what? The blessing brings solid human beings into your life.
Hallelujah.
Divine connections, relationship that are some of best potential. Relationships that open doors in great places. When a man is blessed, everything around him looks good. That's what the blessing will do.
Hallelujah.
So in Ephesians 1 verse 3 said, Blessed be the God and the Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who have blessed us. Who have blessed us. What did he do? He blessed us. And this month, as you walk by the word, as you live by God's word, the blessing will overtake you. And suddenly folks will begin to call you. What can I do for you? How can I help you? How can I stand between this area of your vision? You know, some people work for everything concerning life. Have you seen some people? Everything they get, they work for it. They have to work for everything. But there is something about the blessing that causes folks to remember you without you asking. There is something about the blessing. Let's look at Deuteronomy chapter 28. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
That Deuteronomy 28 is very strategic. I'm reading from the New Living Translation. The NLT translation, and the way he rendered it, I like it so much. Okay, maybe I have to read it from Amplified Translation here. In Amplified Translation, he said, if you will listen diligently to the voice of the Lord your God, did you hear that? If you will do what?
Listen.
Listen. You know, listening is a choice. Someone can decide to listen to you, and someone can decide not to listen to you. And someone can be listening to you, but he's not listening to you. Someone can be listening to you, but he's not listening to you. He's not listening to you. He said, if you will listen diligently to the voice of the Lord your God, being watchful to do all his command, which I command you this day, the Lord your God will set you high above all the nations of the earth. And all these blessings shall come upon you and overtake you.
Hallelujah.
You see, the mission here, the purpose here, is that the blessing overtakes you. The blessing overtakes you. The blessing. When you hear David said, "My cup runneth over," the blessing was overtaken him. He said, "I live through the walls. I have victory." The blessing. The blessing brings protection. There is a protection that a blessed man experiences. The blessing is also like a hedge. You know, God blessed Job to a point that the devil couldn't handle the manifestation of his blessing. Job was one of the rich, was the richest man, blessed man. Job, rich. He wasn't broke. He wasn't broke. The blessing is a reason for the abundance. The blessing of the Lord. And let me say this to you. An individual attitude can keep me away from enjoying the blessing. An attitude someone has can keep them away from enjoying the blessing. An attitude an individual have can stop them from stepping into the blessing. See, someone can be rebellious and not know it. And when I was reading some of the Deuteronomy 28 this morning from verse 15, it said, "Because you will not hearken to the voice of the Lord your God, you are cursed." What? Have you read that verse? If you go down and read it, you will see crazy things. Horrible things. It said, "Because you never hearken to the voice of the Lord your God, your enemies will pursue you, your enemies will run over your children, they will run over your crops."
The blood of Jesus.
What? The heavens will close. Heavens close. Why? Because people are not walking according to God's word. The heavens are closed. Struggle begins. Hardship. Intense struggle. Why? Because they never hearken to the voice of the Lord your God. God can make you rich.
Hallelujah.
It doesn't matter where you live. Doesn't matter where you live. Whether you live in a very impoverished area, nobody is doing business there, nothing is working in that area. The blessing. I noticed something about the blessing, that when a man is blessed, he rises above every form of demonic conspiracy. Let all the witches gather together. All the witches in this world, let them gather together. They can't stop one blessed man. Let them pass him behind. I curse you. I do this. All those rubbish. The blessing is a limit breaker. Don't dare bless man. A man that is blessed, he can sit in one nation and he's influencing people all over the world. What do you call that? The blessing. The blessing. I am blessing minded. The blessing of the Lord. It starts business. They gave him, okay, take this $200 and start a business. And start a business with $200. And the next 1 year, the $200 has grown to $200,000. The blessing.
The blessing
is the reason why things multiply in the hands of people. Have you seen people, they keep starting business all the time? They keep starting business all the time. The more they put the money, the more it sings. But there is the blessed man. Tell it what applies. There is something about the blessing that guides you in the right direction. He said the step of a good man is ordered by the Lord. The step of a good man. He said, let me tell you this. Your relationship with God, let me say it. and everyone that is watching me all over the world this morning, if you are not having a healthy relationship with God, you cannot be in command of the blessing. You may talk about it, but you will never see manifestation. You will not. You may talk about it, oh, I'm going to be blessed, but nothing will happen. You know why? It said if you are hearkening to the voice, obedience is the key to manifesting the blessing. You may be blessed, but sin manifestation is directly related to your degree of obedience. You are blessed in Christ Jesus, but to see the manifestation of the blessing, then you're going to walk in obedience.
I hear.
Obedience. You bought that house, you're living in that house for 5 years, then the Holy Ghost said, come on, it's time to buy another one. God bless you. Don't that you buy a house doesn't mean you will die there. Or you built a house in one place doesn't mean you're going to die there. But the blessing helps you to begin to think in a different dimension. Matthew 21 this morning. The blessing. When you have the revelation of the blessing, given becoming what we live in. When you have the revelation of the blessing, giving becomes a way of living. To you is natural to sow. To you is natural to give. It said to Abraham, I'll bless you and you'll become a blessing. Becoming a blessing is the purpose of the blessing. The reason why you are blessed is that you will be a blessing. The blessing empowers. You may have known someone and maybe you saw a car. And this guy was walking the world, was putting the world first, always walking the world. Maybe somebody may even make a mockery of him and say, oh, look at this fellow. Look at this guy. But if you keep at it, like my pastor would say to me, keep at it. Several years ago, I asked him a question. I said, Pastor, what do you do when you've done everything you're supposed to do, but you never got the kind of results you're supposed to see? Then he said, keep at it. Keep doing those right things. That was why the scripture said, be not weary in well-doing. In due season. There's a word, a due season. But a lot of people never get to due season. You know why? Distraction. Things suddenly knock them up. I don't know if some people, I would like to call it a guess, that they will be walking on the right path, and suddenly they will be close to the due season and something knocked them off. They are working. And when it was the time to reap the harvest, then their attitude changed. Then their lifestyle changed. You know what happens? They never had a vision of the future they wanted. A lack of vision is the reason for deviation. When people lack vision of the kind of life they want to live, they will settle for anything. Anything that comes, they will get to begin. I don't care anything that comes, I will take. God didn't say you will take anything that comes now. You take what is consistent with his word. You take it. One of my spiritual daughters was sharing with me about a guy that wanted to marry her. So this guy was buying things for her, doing things for her. And then when the guy started coming towards her concerning sexual, he said, I don't want to come to that. He said, quickly she pulled off. He said, I don't want that. You know why she made that decision? She knew the kind of future she wants. Some people were those who betray themselves. And someone said, this person is bewitching me. No, actions can bewitch. Wrong actions can do what? Can bewitch. When Paul said, oh foolish Galatians, who has bewitched you? So somebody can be bewitched, and desperation can be the reason. I want you to send me the name and say, wow. I was not there. She could do whatever she do. She doesn't live in this country. I'm not there to see her. But she was accountable. Look at what happened, Pastor. I didn't know bless you. They can't report themselves. See the blessings of the Lord. You see why some folks are rising, they keep rising, they keep rising. What is causing them to rise? You prosper in integrity. A man of integrity, God can speak to a bag to bring him money. God can talk. I've shared a testimony with you one time here. Was going to a church to attend a meeting. And because I was going late, I had to hurry. I hurried. I got to the church. I parked my car. Only to walk into the church. And I forgot my offering. My offering was in my car. What is this? Now hurry. I've now forgotten my offering inside the car. And the church was so crowded that if I stand up, the security person has to follow me. And I don't want to create anything that I have a problem or I'm trying to take care of it. Because my going as everybody were looking, I don't want anybody to be looking at me. So I just take my seat because I was in the front seat. I just sat. The preacher was preaching. I was remembering my offering. I said, I forgot my offering. Then at a point, he said, relax. I got relaxed. And then it was time to give offering. And then the word of the Lord came to me and said, put your hand in your bosom. I was wearing a jacket. As I put my hand in my jacket, inside, I felt something like a paper. He said, draw it out. I draw it out. What I saw was money. I said, this cannot be a joke. Are you kidding me? You know what happened? I put it in the envelope I gave it. I said, maybe my money was in my jacket. I said my money was in my car. As the meeting closed, I hurriedly went to the car. The money was there. Who puts the money there? Oh, you think God doesn't know your email address? You think God doesn't know your account number? You think he doesn't know your needs? He said if he can take care of the birds, they don't sow. They don't work hard. I see these birds, they come to my house all the time, you know. They will fly and just be landing in my compound. Just land like that. They will land on the high tension wire. They will just be having fun, making all kinds of noise. They land on that high tension and they are playing on it. A human being goes there. Will he return that? The moment. But the birds were there. Who is taking care of them? Who is responsible for the security of the birds? If he can think about the bird, the high tension will come. You know when God was creating the bird, there was no high tension wire those days. A generation will come that will tap into the principles of electricity and will be putting the wires that care. Do never care about birds. But like they die or they leave, what's their business? Removing the wires. Oh. But he saw it that a generation will come that will tap into the laws of electricity. And if I don't protect these birds, they will go extinct. Look at God thinking here. Can I say this to you? God is more interested in blessing you. I say God is more what? Interested in blessing you. God is so interested in blessing you. He's more interested in blessing. And the blessing is greater. If you can take the word of God, if you can focus on God's word, if you can say, God, I'm going to walk your word, I'm going to live by your word, you will see the manifestations. This is the month that the blessing will overtake you. As you live by the word, as you live by the word, as you say, God, I'm going to walk the word, I'm going to walk the word. I'm going to be a doer of the word. I'm going to stick with the word until I see results. I'm going to be a diligent doer. I'm going God's way. In Matthew 6:33, it says, seek ye first the kingdom of God. You know why? That is God's way of doing things. If the kingdom is your priority, then the blessing will keep exploding.
Hallelujah.
If the kingdom is your priority, and God blesses people where he sends them. Wherever God sent you to is where he will bless you. Whatever God instructs you to do is what he will bless. Whatever relationship God puts you into, that is what he will bless. So this is why it's important that you're led by the Spirit of God. Like we're sharing yesterday, hearing the voice of God, we said if your mind is not properly renewed, you cannot connect with God's thoughts. And God's thoughts can be very powerful. God's thoughts. He said, my thoughts are higher than your thoughts. And connecting with his thoughts begins with the renewing of the mind. That my mind is able to fellowship with the written word, that I'm able to decode that this is the voice of God and this is not the voice of God. Some people can't know the difference between the voice of God and the voice of feeling and the voice of the devil and the voice of experience. The blessing of the Lord. It said, make it rich. What makes rich? The blessing. What makes rich? The blessing. What makes rich? The blessing. Say the blessings of the Lord make it rich. Empowers you, my God. Because then the children of Israel, they were coming off Egypt with nothing, no security men. No security for them. Nobody to fight for them. But they have the blessing in operation. Why? Because they're the seed of who? Abraham. And because they were the seed of Abraham, the blessing was in operation. I prophesy to you that from this day forward, that you walk in the consciousness of the blessing.
Amen.
You walk in the consciousness. In the consciousness of the blessing. Let me say this to you. You know, some people try to make it to happen. If I don't get it this time, I will not get it anymore. If I don't get this time, I will not. I've learned not to worry about things. I've learned not to worry about things, about people, about situations, because I know God got my back. God has me. So someone may say, oh, I could have done this for you, and then you begin to run after the person. No. The blessing brings provision for honor.
Hallelujah.
The blessing brings provision with honor. The blessing. Work at living the blessed life. This year is going to be a great year. But a great year for people who live by the word of God. Who make God's word the standard for their life. I want to stay with God's word. If you're watching me this morning, wherever you're watching this broadcast, I'd like you to go to YouTube and listen to my teaching on the process to great things. The process to great things is on YouTube. It's one of our recent classic groundbreaking teaching. The process, I've got so many testimony people texting me while they watch that broadcast, the process to great things on YouTube. The process. There is a process to where you're going to. There is a process. And the blessing is the reason why you can make the process.
Hallelujah.
Look at Joseph, denied of everything, but has everything. Was denied of so many things, but this guy stayed focused. When they made a mockery of him, when they despised him, when they betrayed him, when they said all manner of things about him, Joseph was focused. Let me say this to you. Whatever your mates are getting right now that you have not gotten, don't compromise to get it. Just patiently wait. Yours will come better.
Glory.
You heard what I said? Yeah? You heard me? I said, whatever your mates, maybe they are coming telling you, I'm doing this, oh, I'm doing that, oh, I just have this, oh, I just have that, and they are doing all kinds of things to get it. Don't compromise to get it. Just stay with the word. You will have a better version of it.
Glory be to God.
I said what? You will have a better version of that thing.
Thank you, Jesus.
You will have a better, they will watch, so wow! Whatever you, you can, yeah, you will have a better, you know why? Those who honor God, he honors them. He said, those who honor me, I honor them. You know, God is going to honor you. He honors you when you put his word first. Come, put his word first. Put his word first. Put God's word first. Put his word first. Put his word first. No matter the pressure, no matter the challenges, put God's word first. Let his word come first in your action, in your thinking, in your conversation, in your expectation, in your way of doing this. If God's word takes the lead, then you will walk in the blessing. who are taking it. Many may compromise to get it. If you wait for God, you will have his passion.
Glory to God.
If you wait for God, it may look like he's slow right now. Very, very slow. It's slow. Everyone is outrunning you. They are running and they are passing. They are running and they are passing. Everyone is, oh my God. Does it mean I can't really run? Everyone is running and passing me. You know what God is doing? He's preparing the place.
Hallelujah.
He's preparing the people.
Hallelujah.
He's also preparing you. Sometimes he's preparing your husband.
Hallelujah.
The guy is somewhere. He's working on the guy. He's working on the guy. He's fixing the guy for you. And when he's done with fixing the guy, he will bring the guy to you. He's working on your life. He's fixing her. When he's done with fixing her, he will bring her to you. He's working on the house. When he's done, oh my God, do you know folks can start building unknown to them that they're going to speak to you? Don't you know about your business? They're just building, fixing this, fixing this, fixing that. Building unknown to them. To transfer this, what do you call that?
The blessing.
See, if you stay faithful to God's word, you will have the kind of experience that will amaze others. If you will stay faithful to the word of God, if you will say, I'm going to give myself to this word. I don't care what they said. I don't care who they are. If they want me to compromise the word of God, I'm going to walk away. I'm going to allow God's word to come first in my life. And when you make such decision, the best version will come to you.
Amen.
That's what happened. This is why you see some people prosper in dry places. They said the economy is rough and tough, but they just keep prospering. What is causing that? The blessing. Putting the word of God first. Putting the word of God first. If you put your flesh first, it will cost you more later. If you put the word first, it will save you from shame and pain.
Amen.
When you put God's word first, it will save you from shame and pain. The word coming first. A diligent seeker. I've noticed young people who gave their life to Jesus. No, I've noticed people who gave their life to Jesus at the age of 17, 18, and 20, and they got so committed to it. They got so committed to it, they had a different life. I'm telling you. They have fruits of honor, fruits of favor, fruits. You know, you look at them, you know why? He said, remember the Lord your God in your youth. You know why? Because it will help you avoid many mistakes, many carryovers, many issues. So when you come to the Lord, And you get to go in his word. Maybe now you came to the Lord in your 50s. You came to the Lord in your 60s. He's able to do exceedingly. He's able to do abundantly. He's able to do above. But you know what I'm telling young people today? If you're a young person, you're watching this broadcast, you're watching it this morning, wherever you're watching us from this morning, or in this service, it's time for total submission and commitment to the Lord. Don't just hang around church. Don't just play around with church, but be committed in your work with God. Because your commitment will determine the manifestation of your future.
Hallelujah.
Your commitment, yielding to the word, yielding to God, yielding to God, yielding to his word. I've walked this word. This month will make it 21 years. I've been walking this word. For 21 years, this word has not failed. 21 years without a day of regret. 21 years of standing on his word and seeing the word prosper far beyond my imagination. The word of God works. Friend, you can put your whole life in it. The word works. Let's rise to our feet. The word works. The word heals. The word God delivers. The application of the word will reposition your destiny. The application of the word will empower your future. The application of the word will strengthen your vision. The application of the word is what determines the manifestations of the blessing. The application of the word of God is what gives hope to your dreams. The application of God's word is what sustains your faith work. If your faith work is going to be sustained, it's by the application of the word. It says the doers of the word is blessed. Who is blessed? The doers. Those who are committed to living by the word. They choose the one way. There are so many other ways, but they choose to walk by the word. I choose the word way.
Hallelujah.
I choose the word way.
Amen.
I choose to live by the word.
Hallelujah.
I choose to go by the word.
Hallelujah.
Glory be to God. I choose the word way. Thank you, Father. Lift up your voice and begin to bless you. Lord will bless you. Lord will glorify you. Lingaraba Sandagababa. Lord will bless you. We'll thank you. Your word works. Your word heals. Your word saves. I'd like you to begin to pray in the spirit. I'd like you to pray in the Holy Ghost that you're going to be the one first. Concerning your job, concerning that relationship, concerning your see, God will always keep to his word. God will keep to his word. God will always keep to his word. And if you stay with that word, he's going to work it out for your good. He's going to help you come to the front line. The word of God works. The word of God works. It doesn't matter who compromised to build. It doesn't matter who compromised to buy. It doesn't matter who compromised. But if you stick with God's word, you will have the best version of it. You will have the best version of it. If the word of God takes the lead, it may look like you're coming behind right now. It may look like everyone around you is overtaking you. And they look at you and they say, hey, is she still there? Is he still there? It doesn't really matter if you stay in the place of obedience. The word of God will work. The word works. The word works. If you can put it first, it will work for you. God's word, it contains the ability of God. The word of God, in Hebrews chapter 4, verse 12, it said the word of God is quick, it said it's powerful, it said it's sharper than a two-edged sword. God's word. The resources for the future you desire. The key for unlocking the treasures. The word works. I'm going to go by the word. I don't care how many people that are going off God's word, but I'm going by the word of God. I'm going to allow God's word to determine what I do, what I think, and where I go. The word of God works. All you're looking for is in the word. As you walk the word, the blessing will explode. As you walk, you will attract the best. There is something about walking by the word. You will just be attracting solely human beings. Relationship, divine connection, platforms, opportunities, far beyond your human imagination or expectation. You suddenly notice that there is this wave of favor of God around you, and his glory is overshadowing you. You're watching this broadcast this morning, and the Holy Ghost is saying, put the word first. Put the word first. Put the word first. Put the word first. Yes, is it concerning that marriage? Put the word first. Concerning your finances, put the word first. Lay it on tight, no matter how little it is. Every money that comes into your hand, you're tight. Knowing that God is my source. Who is my source? God is my source. Tithing means that you're recognizing God as your source. God is my source. No matter how little it is, you're tithing your way to the top. Thank you, Father. If you're watching this broadcast right now, wherever you're watching this morning, and you don't know Jesus as your Lord and Savior, and you want to receive him into your life, I want to give you the opportunity this morning. You can say this after me. Lord Jesus, I confess with my mouth, I believe in my heart, that God has raised Jesus from the dead. Thank you, Father, for saving me. Amen. If you pray this prayer with us, we are glad that you did. And I pray that the blessings of the Lord will be upon you. We encourage you to keep watching Finish Work TV that's come. And also you can subscribe to our YouTube channel. It's Faithman Teaching on YouTube. You can follow us on the screen. If you're watching for the first time, it's Faithman 2012. And we encourage you that you stay with God's word because it works. God bless you and do enjoy your day. Hallelujah.